Welcome to NIEM-UML tutorial on subsetting and extension. We assume you have a little bit of background, that you know the basics of NIEM and UML. Perhaps you've seen the NIEM-UML high-level introduction. In this tutorial, we'll cover NIEM information model types, reference models and how to subset them, extensions, and NIEM augmentations. If you need more background, please see the tutorial webinars on the NIEM.gov website. NIEM defines specific types of models for specific purposes. The most general is a reference model. A reference model contains content that's intended to be reused across multiple exchanges or sets of exchanges. A subset defines just the parts and pieces of a reference model needed for a particular purpose. Whereas an extension adds new concepts or specializes existing ones. An exchange identifies the particular document types that travel between exchange partners. Information exchanges can be defined using different methodologies, some being more top-down, others more bottom-up. In a top-down methodology, you may start with an extension model representing the high-level concepts of your stakeholders. You could then explore the NIEM reference models, find the concepts that correspond to these, and subset them for your particular purpose. NIEM-UML constructs, such as generalization, augmentation, and references are then used to connect the two. In a more bottom-up scenario, you may start by exploring the NIEM reference models, find the concepts that are useful, create a subset model for those that you want to use, and then extend those to add the classes and properties you need for your purpose, again, using NIEM-UML constructs. Both methodologies will work, as well combinations of methodologies. The best choice may depend on your particular situation. NIEM information models are defined using UML packages. Packages collect combinations of classes and associations and properties for a particular purpose. These are then stereotyped as a NIEM information model, which also includes the namespace concept. A namespace defines whether it's NIEM conformant, its XML namespace string, and its version. Information models add a tagged value that defines the purpose of the model, whether it's an exchange, an extension, a subset, a reference, etc. These stereotypes and tag values should be used for any package intended for use with NIEM. For example, if we looked at the pet adoption extension package in UML, we see it's marked as an information model, that its purpose is set to extension, is defined as being NIEM conformant, it has an XML namespace, and a version. There are also relationships between information models. One information model may use another. So we see it is common for an exchange to use an extension and for an extension to use one or more subsets. A subset model also references its reference model. This means that everything in the subset is conformant with concepts already defined in the reference model. NIEM reference models provide the basis for subsetting and reuse, and each of these is available as a NIEM-UML model. There's a whole library of reference models for different domains and different purposes, and the most general being NIEM Core, NIEM Core being reused across all domains and exchanges. What you do is take a concept out of a reference model. In this example, we're taking person type out of NIEM Core. You then define a subset of it that references that type. In this case, we see that person references person type. This means that everything defined in person must match something defined in person type. Let's look at an example. We'll find person type in NIEM Core, create a subset of it. We'll then load the emergency management domain, another reference model, and look for the alert concept. We'll create an emergency management subset model and subset this alert concept. Note that your UML tool may look slightly differently and that the NIEM PMO doesn't endorse any particular UML tooling. We already have some of the NIEM reference models loaded. Here we see NIEM Core. You'll notice it's quite extensive. We'll search within NIEM Core for something about person. Since there's so many, I'm going to restrict my search to classes. You'll note we found 34 classes having to do with person. Everything from their hair color to their skin type to person type in general. What I frequently like to do is take a class that I found and load it into some scratchpad diagram to take a look. Here we see the person type and the properties of person type. There's also associations from person, and we might want to take a look at these. So we're going to ask the tool to look at the related elements, and I'm going to look for the associations from person within NIEM Core. And we can see there's quite a bit, so I'll ask the tool to lay this out for us. This is one of the mechanisms for exploring the model in UML. We now see that there's not only the properties of person, but quite a few related types. Having decided that person type is what we're looking for, we're going to go back and make a subset of it. So what we've done is select person type out of NIEM Core into our subset model. Now you note that it doesn't have any properties or any associations. We can now ask the tool to show us what properties and associations are available. For instance, we may want to know their birth date. Their name. And social security number. Notice that it brings in these properties. If we look at the NIEM model, we also see that it's necessary to bring in other types of NIEM Core, the date type, the identification type, person name. So we'll also want to select the properties that we need in each of these. For instance, for our purposes, maybe we only need their full name. In this way, we build up a subset of NIEM Core designed for our purpose. But we don't want to limit ourselves to NIEM Core. Say that we also want to include the emergency management domain. You see that the NIEM reference models are readily available. We'll select the emergency management domain and load that into our model. Now we see that the emergency management domain is available as a package. We can now explore the contents of the emergency management domain, not as big as NIEM Core. But let's also go back to our scratch pad and look at this alert type, see if this has the kind of thing that we're looking for. We think it does, so what we'd like to do is create a subset of the emergency management domain in our project. Now for NIEM Core, we already had a subset created. Now we're going to create a new subset. Now we see we have a new subset model created just for emergency management. And as we did before, we'll add the properties that we want for alert type. We now have a subset of emergency management with just the alert type and some of its properties. This can be used in addition to the subsets that we've defined from NIEM Core. Extension models define new concepts not found in the reference models. These can be new classes, such as object types, roles, associations, metadata or adapters, new properties, augmentations, and new classes may or may not subclass concepts found in the reference models. Let's look at another example. We'll create a new extension model for alerts. We'll add a subclass of alert type in the extension. We'll add a new enumeration for the kind of alert, whether it's silent or an alarm. And then we'll add an alert kind property to alert type. While we already have an extension model, we'll create another one by way of example. We'll create a package. And look at its specification to add a stereotype. We'll now bring in alert type from our subset and create a new class. That extends it. We'd also like an enumeration to hold our alarm type. What we'd like to do now is add a property to alert type extension for our alarm kind. We now have a proper extension of alert type, including our alarm kind. NIEM also defines the concept of augmentations. Augmentations allow new properties to be defined for a class across multiple namespaces and then arbitrarily combined. In this case, we see that telephone number in pet adoption uses the core definition of telephone number as well as an augmentation that includes the telephone type. An augmentation is like any other class. However, it has the augmentation type stereotype. A class may then inherit any number of augmentation types, and the properties will be combined. Optionally, an augmentation type may define the class that it augments. In this case, telephone number augmentation is restricted to only augment telephone numbers. Another way to restrict what an augmentation augments is at the property level. A property may have an augmentation application to a specific class. In this case, we see telephone number augmentation is restricted to only augmenting telephone numbers. However, other properties using telephone number augmentation could augment other classes. Let's go back to our example. We would like our alert kind to be able to be arbitrarily included in any number of classes. So we're going to change our alert type to an augmentation. We'll then define a new alert type that inherits the initial alert type as well as this augmentation. We'll then explore the XML to see how this looks. In this example, we'll make alarm kind code more reusable. We'll do that by changing this to an augmentation. And appropriately renaming it. We'll now add in a new alert type. That inherits both base alert type and the augmentation. We also want to say that alert augmentation type augments alert type. That means the alarm kind code property only applies to alert types, which makes perfect sense. What we're going to do now is generate the MPD so we can look at the XML. The generation is complete, so let's look at one of the schemas. Here we see the XML, and we can identify the alarm code, the augmentation type that uses the alarm code, and the alert type referencing the property that includes the augmentation. In this way, we can see that alert type includes both the original definition of alert as well as the augmented alarm kind code. This concludes the NIEM tutorial on augmentation and extension. For more information on NIEM-UML, please see the webinars on the NIEM.gov website. Thank you for your interest in NIEM-UML.